Hey guys, welcome to Plum Fantasy, everything nails and makeup. Today we're going to be doing a nail, not nails. So we're going to start off with sanitizer. We're going to sanitize our fingers and sanitize the pushing tool. Please follow us on Instagram and like, comment, share this video. So today I am pushing back my cuticles. I don't know what I said today. Pushing back the cuticles just to clean out all that dirt that is under the cuticles. Then we're going to be scraping it off using the opposite tool from the cuticle pusher. So we're just doing this in order to make sure that the AcryGel that I'm going to be using does not lift in about 2 weeks to 3 weeks. It just grows out with the nail nicely. So that's what we're going to be doing. Now this is my first video ever on YouTube, so please like, please subscribe, and we're going to be teaching you a lot of things. Like, I am going to be teaching you a lot of things, so that is great. So I just dusted off the dust from the cuticle, and then now I'm going to be filing using a 100-180 grit file. I'm going to be using the 180 side just to buff out the nail. This is very important. Don't skip this step if you want to make sure that your nails do stay a long time. So that's what I'm doing. Basically, I'm just going forth and just buffing lightly. This video is sped up, so it kind of like shows like as if like I'm really into it, but no, I'm just buffing lightly, and I'm gonna use a buffer just to buff a little bit, make it smooth. Just extra steps that I really like to do, making sure that the nails look good. The prep work actually is good. So I'm gonna take the file again and just file my nails down, so that when I'm gonna be using nail forms, so that it doesn't show on the nail itself, because I'm not going to be putting any polish or gel polish on top of this nail. So what I'm going to be doing, using a nail form, in my coming up videos I will literally show you how to use a nail form. I'll show you how to shape using a nail form. I'll show you everything you need to know, like basic 101s. So yeah, I'm just going to be fitting the nail form onto my nail and making sure that it sticks right. Throughout this video you'll see that the nail form is not as sticky as I wanted it to be, but I just kept on adjusting that just to make sure that, yeah, it doesn't fall off. Imagine. So like I said before, I'm going to show you guys how to literally apply nail forms and how to get them to the right shape, and how to shape using AcryGel or polygel, if you want to call it whatever it is you want to call it. But basically it's just a hybrid of gel and acrylic, so it's much easier if you're a beginner to use that. It's very much safe, if you ask me. Excuse me, I feel like I'm getting a cough. So you'll hear little, you know, my voice not going good. So what I'm doing now, after applying the nail form, I'm just going to apply some dehydrator. This is the Cody dehydrator. I'm going to apply that, let it dry. Just takes 2 seconds, and then I'm gonna go in with the Planet Nails acid primer, and I'm just gonna do one swipe, because it's not like, if you're using acid primers, please just do one swipe, and if you're using a non-acid primer, you can just do 2 coats. So yeah, I'm just doing 1 coat, and then I'm gonna go in with rubbing alcohol from Discam. This is 91% rubbing alcohol. They call it paso poco alcohol in America. It's rubbing alcohol here. And I'm going to be using that with this double-ended brush and spatula to be picking up the AcryGel or polygel. And the rubbing alcohol is just to help the polygel not to stick onto the brush, just to make it a smooth application. So we're gonna go ahead with base coat. A really important step if you want your nails to go further, you know, hitting that 3 week mark, staying on until you get the opportunity or the time to just do your nails again. So we're gonna brush that on. I just do one coat of it, and we're gonna place the nail in the nail lamp and cure it for 1 minute to 60 seconds in an LED lamp. So yeah, and then after that I'm gonna be using this AcryGel, and it's color number 19. I don't know the name. I'll link it down below on the description box. So I'm gonna take the other side, the spatula side, and dip it into the alcohol and just remove that and then put it on the nail. This helps it, just like I said before, not to stick on the tool or the brush. So that's what I do, and then I didn't get enough of it, so I added another pencil ball. Yeah. Then I'm using the brush side, putting it into the rubbing alcohol, and then just damping it on the paper towel just to get rid of the excess alcohol that is in there. And I'm just gonna pat and brush on the polygel, which AcryGel. I don't really know what to call it, guys. Like, there's so many names for it. And yeah, and you'll notice that throughout all of my videos that I'm going to be uploading on YouTube, I'm going to be using this AcryGel / polygel from different brands, of course. And I'm also going to make sure that I give you my honest review. I started doing nails like a while back, so I kind of have the hang of it, but I'm still a beginner when it comes to these things. So it's very much important for me to share it with you guys. You know, what are girls for? You know, we share stuff. So I'm not gonna hide all the things. But I would really suggest, if you can't do your nails at home, just get a professional to do them. Like, with professionals, you have that quality, you know. But you can also learn. You know, I'm all about learning. I don't like spending my coins, guys, unless it's an investment, okay? I have to invest. So if I'm investing on myself and I'm making sure that this is gonna go a long way, then yes, I'm gonna invest in a full kit to make sure that in the long run I don't really have to go to someone else to do my nails, because I'm a cheapskate. But it's a one-stop thing. So I'm just smoothing out the polygel and making sure that the edges are clean, the shape that I want. I went for a square. Yeah, it's a square. I went for a square shape with this. So I'm just making sure that I smooth it out very well so that I file less. This is a trick, another tip, if you can say. If you're going to use a polygel, just try to make sure that it's smooth, really smooth, so that when you come to filing, it's very easy for you to file, rather than you having to file off a lot of product, you know. Save time. I'm very lazy, so yeah, I'm very lazy. So I'm gonna put that into the nail lamp and cure it for 60 seconds in an LED lamp. And if you have an LED / UV lamp, it's 2 minutes. So 120 seconds. So I'm gonna go ahead and remove the nail form, and we are going to use a gel wipe off solution so that we wipe off this techy layer. I'm going to go into detail with my other videos on how to use polygel. This is just the first video, you know, kind of rushed kind of situation. Excuse me, I'm sorry. But I'm going to help you try as hard as I can to help you guys get the perfect nails. And I'm going to show you some designs as well in the future, but this is just a little demonstration. Yes, and I talk too much. I should put on black brown music. I like fantasy, so you'll hear a little bit of fantasy music at the back. So we're gonna file. First of all, we're gonna file the sidewalls, making them straight as possible, so that we have that crisp straight line when you're looking from it from the when you're looking at your nail from the side as well as from the top. You'll have that beautiful straight line. And I'm just gonna file at the edge of the nail, making it straight, you know, and then I'm gonna file on top. I'm gonna also upload a filing routine and how you should do it, like in real time, because this is much sped up and it's gonna help you. I pray it does. Yeah, so it's gonna help you. So I'm gonna do that. File. I'm just filing. So you guys, I would like you to like and subscribe to this nail channel and makeup channel. It's mostly going to be nails rather than makeup. For makeup, it will be that occasional, you know, I'm gonna do makeup today days. So it's not going to be a lot. There is not going to be a lot of makeup tutorials, because I feel like everybody's just doing makeup tutorials these days. It's just, I'm over it. But it's great if you guys want to learn about makeup. I'm happy to share, because this is about sharing. It's a sharing space. If you have questions to ask, please go ahead and ask. Like I said, this is just a video that is going to be uploaded, my first video ever, kind of like a trial run. I'm pretty sure the content that is going to come after this video is going to be great. And I talk a lot, so I really talk a lot. I hope I'm not boring you. I sometimes get bored of me talking, you know, just listening to yourself do it. So I'm just right here buffing the nail. I'm not actually buffing, I'm actually using the other file to file off, make it smooth. And there you go. And I'm just gonna buff off that nail. Buffing is literally removing scratches from the nail. And what I've realized with AcryGel / polygel is that when you file with a heavier file, like a 180 grit file, you will get scratches, and that will not look good after like putting on your top coat. It does not look good at all. You have the scratches that so it's good to have a buffer to buff off those scratches to make it smooth again. It will look absolutely like $100, like you guys already did your nails at a professional at a person who does nails professionally, because I don't. I'm just that girl, like, who likes things. I'm tandizinto, guys, I don't want to lie. I'm tandizinto, so that's why I am So I'm just gonna go in with top coat, and this I'm just painting it on. The color of this polygel, like I said, it's number 19, and it's just a nice nude color. It's kind of like peachy nude. It's very pretty. You'll see that after the final result when I'm done showing you. Now we're going to clean off the gel that might have gotten onto your skin. We're gonna clean that off. It's not good to clear gel which has been on the skin, so we're just cleaning that off, making sure there's no gel on the skin and there's only gel on the nail. This is gel top coat. So yeah, we're gonna chill for 60 seconds and I'll eat that. And this is the final result. I'm sorry for the light is blocking what is perfection. We're gonna use a cuticle pen just to bring back the oils that we might have streaked earlier. Thank you guys for watching. See you soon.